Keep going, go around so you can see from all sides. If you're going through glass, I'll promise it will come back.
Jamestown Monument.
Land beyond your irresistible. Still, I've no complaint. We tavern keepers usually did right well. Small though it be, this was the capital. And for a long time, the chief seaport of Virginia. The ships arriving and departing, especially those bringing in fresh settlers, kept the tavern thus far. And when the General Assembly met, with counselors and purposes from all the colony gathering here, the sound was like a bird. During these times, nearly anyone with walls and a roof would turn a foundry. Those times would have been much dreary without its cabin. Not only did our snug rooms provide shelter for travelers, it offered a tasty alternative to the town's industrial water, it was also a meeting place for people. While what with fires here, which regularly built the state house down, we often served as capital. I myself once hosted a 4,000 pounds of tobacco. When Governor Nicholson took the capital from Jamestown, he took its heart as well. The fragile flower of a Jamestown, having germinated a great colony, soon faded.
Settlement that burnt down. There's more of it around scattered in different areas.
White-skinned men in strange garb tied their great boats to the nearby trees. Their weapons spoke with a terrible noise. These strange men, these English, built huts bigger and stronger than ours. They had iron tools. We gave them corn and meat for iron tools and pretty beads. The English stayed. They called this worthless land Jamestown. There were sickly people, these English. Many died. More English came. Some were cruel to my people. They took our food and burned our villages. Their sickness made my people die.
Doesn't look too bad.
It looks very good. Even if it don't look too bad. You should have Mexico. It's a dogwood, John. There's one further down, too. Why we got quiet.
Where's
build it.